So this was the first script that you listened to?
I haven't listened to it. You're letting all the secrets out now.
Okay. Fantastic actor like Parvathy at home.
He just basically wanted you out of the house. 20% of Anjali Menon's patients. Working with Anjali can sometimes be excruciating.
Hi Rajveta, welcome to Film Companion.
Thank you.
Hi Nazriya, welcome to Film Companion. I'll start with you, Nazriya. You're coming back after a gap of almost 4 years. And Malayalam cinema had this curse of very talented actresses getting married very early and quitting films and then coming back much later to do mature roles. Like, and you got married very early, you're coming back very early, you're still in your 20s. And that's a very unique thing happening. So how is it going to shape your future career, and how is it getting back to films?
Well, firstly, I don't think so much, like, you know, like, even when I was going to do Koode, I didn't think it's been 4 years since I've done a film. But then, obviously, like, when I was going to the sets, I was a little worried, you know, if I remember it or not, and all of that was always there. But when I went, it was all the same. I'm like, oh, it's still the same thing. It feels the same. So, and the kind of support and love that I've got from social media, it doesn't really feel like, you know, I was gone anywhere.
And you both are working together for the first time. I've read in many interviews that you hadn't met each other till the shooting started.
I think we've seen each other or something in an award function when she was like, I think 5 or 6 or something. At least she looked like
like the first time he met me also, he's like, you're smaller than Ali. I'm like,
so yeah, how was it getting to know each other? How was it playing brother and sister for the first
actually
time?
We got to know each other even before we met, because what happened was, she's spoken about this in a couple of interviews, even before the shoot started, like I think a couple of months, 3-4 months before the shoot started, Anjali had made this iMessage group for, and it had just Anjali, Nazri and me. And she made the group and she posted a message saying, hi guys, I mean, this is for both of you to start talking to each other and to break the ice. And then about 90 minutes later, she sends a message saying, I'm worried that there won't be any more ice to break by the time.
I can see the bond very well here.
Yeah, so I mean, by like, even before we met each other, we had known each other for a while through this group actually. So the first time we met, I remember I had just reached Ooty, which is where we shot the film, and Anjali and Nazri were already there. So
they have worked together already.
Correct. And I was in my room, and there was a knock on the door, and I opened, and it was both of them. And for some strange reason, I was wearing a black t-shirt and a black tracks, and she was also wearing a black t-shirt and a black tracks. So Anjali made us both sit on the couch and took a picture and then showed it to us and said, you guys, like,
no. Yes, I don't mind believing that now.
Yeah, so it was really one of those, I don't have the faculty of making friends very easily and all, but I think she is an expert in it. You need to be seriously talented not to be friends with Nazri after meeting her.
So, letting all the secrets out now.
Okay.
So yeah, so I mean, it took 10 minutes of meeting each other for Anjali to kind of realize that, okay, now the challenge is going to be keeping these guys under control, you know?
Yeah, she keeps telling, how do I shoot with you too? I'm like, you asked for it.
Yeah, then there was Parvathy, of course. Yeah. Both of us have worked with her. And so then it became like this team of three. We were in the same hotel. We used to go to the location together. We came back together. We pretty much had all our meals together. So it was like 2 months of, you know, this team of three together. So it was great. Actually, very, very few films kind of managed to create that atmosphere. In my career, I mean, those classmates, which was quite similar. After that, maybe Amar Akbar Antony had the same thing going on.
The bromance.
Yeah. And then maybe a bit of it happened in Adam Joanne, because Naren, Bhavna, me, Lena, all of us have worked together. Then it was this film. And this acting took it to a whole new level, because all of us became so close to each other that it was great. And I seriously do think that shows on screen.
And when I was thinking about it, like, when we look back at Malayalam cinema, there hasn't been many films which portrayed brother-sister relationships. Like, it was always stereotypical for the sister's characters, like, she has to be saved from the villain by the hero, and it's always like, Amme de etan vannu. That is the main thing that the sister does. So why hasn't been there like a proper brother-sister relationship so far, and what was your reference point approaching this film?
Firstly, I think it's not a very easy premise to write a film on, because it's one of those things that can very easily slip into cliched melodrama. Like you just said, you know, when you're speaking about two siblings, there are some dynamics that we as Malayali film watching audience are comfortable with.
Yeah.
To step outside of it and then to design a relationship and then to portray that on screen is not a very easy thing to write. Anjali's managed that beautifully. Secondly, I think even within that, the dynamic in this film is very different because it's the sister saving the brother here. Okay. Now, why I say that, you'll understand when you see the film.
And what do you have to say about that?
I'll say because there wasn't Joshua and Jenny before. Like, people are calling us now soul siblings, and I completely agree to it. Like, the minute I saw him, the minute we started working, I'm like, oh, this shouldn't be difficult because I already feel that way.
Yeah, so I can, I mean, rest assured, it's not your usual brother-sister story for sure, that I can assure you. Okay. Now, whether people find it as exciting as we have found it while doing the film and now having seen the footage, whether people share the same excitement about it as we do, that I don't know, but yeah.
Let's hope for the best for
yeah.
that. So, why Koode? Why did you decide to pick on this film? I'm sure you must have been offered several movies in these 4 years.
Frankly speaking, yeah. After my wedding, I wasn't listening to scripts.
Okay.
So people keep asking me why haven't you been? Because frankly, like I was traveling continuously, and then I was settling down. We were, you know, getting our own place, and I was settling down. And people keep asking me, weren't you bored? It's been 4 years. What are you doing? I'm like, I'm a person who likes to do nothing. So get used to it. And Koode happened, like, I remember it was a year back. That Anjali called and told me, you know, I have something like this in
mind. So this was the first script that you listened to?
Yeah.
Okay.
I haven't listened to anything.
I think it's partly because I assume Malayalam cinema just decided.
Assume
that, you know, Nazriya is not going to act anymore because she just wants another kind of life, and which she's very comfortable with, by the way. I'm telling you, she's still not decided if she wants to keep doing films. I know that.
But
she's very happy being home, you know, with her doggy, you know. She's just very happy there. And so I just think that when Anjali first called me and told me this, this premise, this subject, and then she said, you know, this is what I'm thinking of, you and Nazriya. Because I was also not thinking Nazriya, because I didn't think Nazriya would come back. When she said that, it immediately made sense to me, and I thought, yeah, I mean, if Nazriya says no, this film can't be made the way it's, because Anjali, I think, wrote it for Nazriya, or maybe, I don't know why, but after seeing the film, I can assure you, one unanimous opinion that will form from the film is, this was the Nazriya role, you know, having known her in person. Jenny is so much Nazriya. Like, okay. I've gone through multiple moments in front of the camera when the camera is rolling, when I've thought, hang on, is that Nazriya speaking to Prithviraj, or is that, you know, is that
yeah. Well, like, yeah, Koode was the right thing. Like, when I heard Koode, like, everyone keeps telling, when you make a comeback, it needs to be very different. I'm like, no, but Jenny, I could relate. It's me. Like, you know, I was so sure of that. And I had decided, like, you know, it's not going to be something like, I'm going to do something really different when I do something after 4 years. I wanted to do something that people would expect out of, you know.
You've worked with Anjali before in Manjari Kuru, her first film.
Yeah.
And how has it been different working as a lead actor this time? That was a guest appearance. And
yeah.
What difference in sensibility and perspective has she brought, like, as compared to a male director?
See, I really don't think that sensibilities differ on the base of gender.
No.
I mean, either you're a filmmaker who really knows what you want and how you want to do it, or you're a filmmaker who doesn't know it. Biggest compliment I can give Anjali is actually the fact that I don't think there is any difference in Anjali between Manjari Kuru and Koode.
Oh.
And I mean that as a compliment.
Okay.
Because when I did Manjari Kuru, I saw this new young filmmaker so focused and so sure about what she wanted to do. I shot for that film for one day and I dubbed for it one day because it had my narration all through. And she was so clear about exactly what she wanted, even in terms of, even when I was dubbing the voiceovers, she used to tell me, you know, can you slow down a bit there, because I want that word to overlap in that shot. She was so sure about it. And at those days, I thought this is coming from a filmmaker, a new filmmaker who's lived with a dream for many years and then suddenly, ultimately is getting to make it. She's still the same way. And as an actor, I can tell you, working with Anjali can sometimes be excruciating. Now, let me explain. Because, see, Anjali will have something in her mind that she anticipates will happen in a frame. Okay, it might be a master shot involving 8-9 actors. There'll be something that she wants, that she wants to happen within the frame. It might not. Every actor will be doing his or her part correctly. She'll just keep repeating the shot. And we'll ask Anjali, Anjali, is there anything different? No. You keep doing the same thing. And we'll just have to keep doing it. And she'll just keep doing it till that magic happens. And that might be the 10th take, 11th take, but that's her process.
She doesn't tell you what she wants, like that magic, whatever she wants.
No, she does sometimes. Sometimes she doesn't. As an aspiring filmmaker, I know that sometimes it cannot be voiced out. You know, you can't really tell an actor what you're looking for, but you know that what you wanted has not happened. I can understand that. But the thing is, most filmmakers would give up at one point. Anjali just does not. I mean, the option of, okay, that's not happening, let's think of something else, is not there as far as Anjali is concerned.
That will happen.
Yeah, I mean, she will. Yeah, she will make it happen. So, for whoever she's going to work with next, I can tell you, it might at times be an excruciating process, but it'll be worth it in the end. Because when you see the film, you kind of realize, okay, I mean, it's worth surrendering to her process.
And what about you? What are your experiences working with her in two films back to back?
Well, what I felt at first itself was Bangalore Days was a little bigger team.
Yeah.
There was a bigger star cast and all that. But from that set to this set, what's not changed is the kind of atmosphere she builds for you, you know, to be comfortable with your co-stars. And that's amazing. I think we also, like, you know, she was the one who took the initiative, you know, did the iMessage group. I think that's very important, at least for actors like us. Like,
yeah.
We work almost the same way. Like, you need to be comfortable with that person, especially when you play siblings. You need to be comfortable in a different level. I think that she really did during Bangalore Days also and during Koode also. And that really means a lot even after the film gets over.
Okay. I mean, I've said this before in interviews, that I've seen filmmakers spend so much time on getting the right location, setting up a backdrop, designing a shot, lighting up a shot. I mean, eventually a shot might take 4 hours to set up. And then finally, when the actors are in front of the camera, it's like, okay, let's go.
Yeah.
It actually should be the other way around, you know? I mean, the backdrop and the lighting and everything is secondary. Because even if all that is great, if your actors don't get it right and if you don't get that moment created between your actors, nothing matters. Anjali's got that. Everything else is secondary. For her, what happens between the actors in front of the camera is be all, end all of it. And she says that. She says, I mean, she's a filmmaker, she's a writer who is based on performances. Which is why I think Anjali's films will always have very good performances from actors.
Like every day we used to spend time like in the van or like just together with the actors, like even if everything is ready.
The pace is the opposite, you know. I mean, she'll hurry up a little to light up, she'll set up the shot and all that, then she'll bring in the actors, which then is then the process starts. And everybody will have to wait because she'll come and sit in the spot with the actors. She'll discuss the shot. She'll ask us. She won't give me lines. She'll ask me to make up my own lines. And all this takes time. So I can already sense people around us, like the technicians around us thinking, come on, I mean, yeah, it's time. But no, that is secondary. For her, she has to. So yeah, I mean, I won't recommend every filmmaker taking this process on, because it's not something everyone will be able to pull off. But Anjali does it with Elan, and it's hats off to her.
And as you just said, you were given an English script, I heard.
Yeah.
And you were asked to improvise your lines, most of it.
Yeah.
I think.
All of it almost. Yeah.
Okay. So how was that process? You haven't been following that process. Almost all films will have a bound script for you.
Yeah.
So
no, I think Anjali, Anjali had heard that I kind of subconsciously memorize lines, which I do. It's not an exercise I do. I don't like sit and by heart the script, but by the time I reach the shoot of a film, I end up knowing my lines and knowing the other characters' lines, mostly, most films.
Yeah, many people have told that you have a photographic memory.
Yeah, he does. Trust me on that.
I think in Parvathy's interview, I think she had mentioned.
Yeah, see, I don't know how much of it helps me as an actor. It probably doesn't. But so Anjali had heard this. So she wanted me to take that facet away. Okay. Right? So she said, I am very confident of your language. You know, your Malayalam is good. So I'm going to give you the English script, and I'd like you to just say what you think you should in Malayalam. Now, it was okay with scenes with her and all, because I kind of anticipated what she would say, and more often than not, she'd say that. Okay.
Likewise.
Yeah, but sometimes you'd be in a scene with a new actor or somebody who you've never met before, and they would have been given a Malayalam line.
And the others were all given
lines. Yeah, they would have been given the Malayalam line, and I'd be there, and I'd have to then listen to what he or she is saying so that I can kind of manipulate the English line in my head to suit the reply. So okay. That was an interesting.
And he remembers every English line. That is very important. So it's quite easy.
Even while he's speaking the Malayalam.
Quite good.
It's not easy, but I'm just saying that it was new for me. Okay. It was new. Again, I mean, it takes time. It takes time because two actors are in frame, they're speaking to each other. We'll do a rehearsal. That's when we first discover, oh, hang on, this is not working. So when we kind of, you know, tinker with our lines a bit, then we sort of change maybe the positions to suit the lines. So it takes time. So it requires a filmmaker with unbelievable amounts of patience. And walking into Lucifer as a director, my biggest wish to God is that I get 20% of Anjali Menon's patience. Yeah.
Her patience is something that you need to talk about. Like, because so many times she would come to sit and discuss a scene with us, and we'll just be playing. Not in the mood. And she's like, guys, please.
She has to shoot a movie.
Yeah, I mean, she was really patient with us, okay? Because we were fooling around all the time. Like, really, I mean, fooling around all the time.
But she wanted that. She's like, you guys should be so comfortable. You guys should be fooling around. And she's like, bye.
And how was it for you when he was like improvising his lines? Was he unpredictable? Like, how was it affecting your acting?
No, with her it would take us 2 minutes.
Our
scenes were the easiest to do in the film.
Okay.
Like for me, I'm the most relaxed, or I'm not looking at the paper or anything when I'm doing the scene. I'm like, oh, it's only with brother. We'll manage. And we keep telling Anjali, like, with full confidence, we'll kill it. Don't worry. She's like, don't you think you should just read?
Yeah, with her it was very easy. I mean, I she's probably the easiest co-star I worked with.
Because we're just the same.
Yeah.
We don't know what others think.
They might have a different opinion.
But this is our opinion.
In fact, I was just preparing for the interview. I noticed a lot of things common about you. You both came into films at a very young age playing lead roles.
Okay.
You both have played good roles in Tamil and Malayalam. You have fan bases there. You have occasional singers in your movies. And this year, you both are turning into independent producers.
Oh, yeah.
So, how is it being a producer?
You want to ask me this first?
Yeah, first you.
Please.
He has been a producer.
No, I think we're fresh into this. Like a fresh perspective on it.
He knows everything about it and he's purposely doing it.
I know that he knows everything.
Well, producing wasn't as easy as I thought. Like, I think I should stick to acting in once in 4 years. Like, production side, like this time I've not got involved like with the numbers or anything of that sort. It's more of on the creative side.
Okay.
So it's about, you know, suggestions and that my mental support. It's only that I've not gotten involved with the numbers or anything.
She might not give out this vibe, but she has a very keen sense of filmmaking.
Okay.
I would be more than happy to have her as my co-director, assistant. She has a very keen sense of filmmaking.
That's interesting.
Although she doesn't look or sound it, she has a very keen sense of filmmaking.
He has decided to produce my film also when I direct.
I will. I'm telling you today, I will.
On record.
Yeah, on record I will.
Okay, so and how is 9 progressing? It's quite a big film.
We are done actually. The shoot is done. The challenge behind 9 was that the logistics behind it, because we were shooting a major portion of the film in Manali, in peak season. Mm-hmm. And then we shifted to Spiti, which is like a 13-hour car ride, and to actually travel with a 100-member unit with so much equipment. It's a very infrastructure, equipment-heavy film. All those were the challenges. Other than that, I mean, designing a project or producing a film is not really new to me. I've been part of that process even before. But yeah, even for what the film is, it's very new. So it's an attempt, and I put my conviction and my money behind it. So let's see what happens.
And director Ranjith is playing your father in the film. He was the one who launched you. You worked with him in several films. How is it working with him for the first time?
Like, it was my first time working with him. So initially, like I said, he's a much senior director, and you know,
he appears quite intimidating.
Yeah, like, so I was a little, like, you know, a little scared, and you know.
Oh, that was scared you.
Later on, well, it didn't take time, like, you know. It was quite fast where all that scared disappeared, and you know, it was fun. Like, you know, in set we would be like, oh, where is she? Where is he? Like, and we would just hang.
It's a very interesting kind of an anti-casting, actually, because like you said, Ranjithetan has a persona, which mostly what you assume about him is true. He can be very intimidating. He's very eloquent and coherent in what he puts across in terms of ideas and words and lines and everything. When I first told Anjali, why don't we speak to Ranjithetan, my thing was, he'd come and be so uncomfortable doing this that we'll get something very new, you know, very, very new.
Okay.
So Anjali immediately liked the idea, and she spoke to Ranjithetan, and then agreed. I lied to him saying, oh, it's nothing, it's 5 days, 6 days, 10 days and all. He's there throughout, okay, from beginning to end. And after coming to Ooty, he's like, you told me it was done.
And then we calmed down saying, like, every evening, let's catch up.
Yeah, so what surprised me about Ranjithetan was, he's a filmmaker, he's a writer, but the way he so totally surrendered to Anjali's process, you know, that I think even it was an eye-opener for even actors like us, because he never had the temptation to kind of think, why don't I say this line like that, you know. He would always just stick to the text and stick to what Anjali told him to do, and it was a very good performance. It's a, for those who know Ranjithetan especially, you will know how good a performance it is, because it is not anything like him. I seriously do think it's one of the finer character actor portrayals in Malayalam cinema recently. Again, it's my own personal opinion. When I watched his scenes in the dubbing suite, I was really moved. It could also be skewed perspective because I know him. So, you know, I don't know.
And Parvathy is also playing a very important role in the film. You both have worked with her earlier. And she has been going through a lot of online bullying and cyber abuse and all that while she was doing this film, and still continuing. So how was it working with her during this tough time, and was she ever bothered about that or anything?
She is one of the, I mean, let's face the fact that she's one of the finest actors of our generation.
Of course.
Male or female, she's one of the finest actors of our generation. And why she is so good is because, again, she's so true as an actor, you know. She's not like either one of us. She will prepare for the scene, and you know, she'll be there in the moment. And you realize that in front of the camera, she doesn't even bother about what's happening around her, nothing. So yeah, I mean, she was going through a tough time in terms of what was happening outside the film set. But when she was in front of the camera and when it was short time, she would just, as always, you know, just switch off and switch on into another person. And she plays a very complex character in the film. It's a very deep, complex character. And as always, she's pulled it off very, very well. I mean,
she's like a very, really hardworking person. She like works for a character, and she likes to be that character even before, you know, the short starts or the scene starts rolling. So, I mean, it's amazing how it can be done.
Yeah.
And I just saw a beautiful song between you both.
Yeah, yeah. We launched that song today, yeah. Yeah, that again, what the edit that you're seeing of that song is not how the song is in the film.
Okay.
Now, why we can't put the film's version out, you'll realize when you see the film.
So it's suspense.
Yeah.
Okay.
But even, like I said, that it's not a usual brother-sister story. Neither is it a usual love story, you know. It's not your typical boy meets girl, they fall in love story. It's a much more complex, mature, real kind of a. In fact, I think what something very new about Koode is the love track.
Okay.
That is something that you will not see in a lot of Malayalam films. In fact, in a lot of Indian films either. It's a very new kind of a relationship between Joshua and Sophie. And it's beautifully done, beautifully written and beautifully shot. And yeah, I mean, I really do think that that will be a very new, fresh angle in Koode.
And what about the rest of the cast who are all, I think, Roshan and Siddharth are playing a part?
Yeah, that's the like college bit of it. Jenny's college and Jenny's friends. Roshan is there, Siddharth is there, Darshana is there. Okay.
Yeah, so Roshan was our Roshan was our like, you know, punching bag. We used to like rag him. We used to rag him every day. But really fine young actor, very good actor, very hardworking boy. And I really hope that, you know, he finds that kind of cinema and that kind of people to work with.
Really one definitely like that.
Yeah, movie. Yeah. I mean, and this film I think will do him a lot of good. Really good actor. And he's done very well in the film.
Nazriya, how does it help you when you have like a fantastic actor like Parvathy Faasil at home? Do you guys discuss movies and discuss your characters, scripts and everything?
Like, scripts, I don't know if they really discuss in detail or anything. But yeah, of course, we do keep telling if there's an inquiry like this. This is or a synopsis like that, we speak to each other. Otherwise, actually, we don't really speak about work at home. But yeah, he is definitely like, you know, seeing him is an encouragement about, you know, seeing this very seriously, like, you know, with so much dedication and hard work is, you know, something amazing. I think even after our wedding, he was the one who used to keep asking me, aren't you listening to any scripts? Like, why are you so lazy? I'm like, please.
He just basically wanted you out of the house.
I knew he was going to say that. But yeah, anyways. So yeah, he used to keep asking me, you know, you should listen to scripts, like, you know, it doesn't happen with everyone that, you know, people are calling and inquiring. And
I saw how wonderfully he put up a post on Facebook about your comeback and...
Fahadh was very much part of the shoot actually, because I mean, it was really sweet. He used to come like almost every week. So we spent a lot of time in UP. I've known him like from a very young age, even before cinema and all that. I've known him. I don't think I've ever spent so much time with him. That happened through her. And yeah, it was really nice. Shana used to drop in, Supriya was there, my daughter was there, and then my daughter and Nazriya just hit it off.
Best friends, like, you know, we're like, and I have to go back and play with her, so okay. Yeah, we have to finish this fast.
You've got two back-to-back releases, like last week there was My Story and this week Koode is coming out. Usually it's advised that stars shouldn't have like back-to-back releases. Do you think these films coming back-to-back will affect them in any way?
No, I agree. If given a choice, I would never have designed it such that two films, come back-to-back.
Two big films.
Correct. But as far as Koode is concerned, that the fact that it will reach theatre somewhere around the first week of July was fixed quite long back. My Story's release date was fixed only very recently. And of course, I mean, when they decide to release My Story on such and such date, they are also aware that 1 week down the line there is another film of mine that's already scheduled for release. So there it's the choice is not the actors, the choice is the distributors or the producers. Of course, I can give them suggestions and recommendations that listen, this might not be the best thing to do, which I did, but the choice is theirs.
A lot has been going on in Malayalam cinema right now, different associations, different stands. You're one of the very few people who took a brave stand when all this was going on. Do you think all these arguments and debates would lead to a progressive environment in Malayalam cinema?
I personally don't even see what is brave about my stand. Okay, I mean, I know people qualify it as like a something. I just thought that was what I was thinking inside. So that's a stand I took. I don't know about what the current scenario will evolve into. But I really do hope that, you know, when the current younger lot, you know, at least they go through the years in their career, you know, we manage to create an environment which is better for everybody. I don't just mean for women, you know, I just mean for new filmmakers, a more transparent system of cinema being made, like how digital filmmaking is made cinema so accessible. You know, I just think there will have to be some evolution of the work environment where it becomes more more of a team sport, more of a you know, a democratic affair. So I hope all this in the end, that's where we are headed to. And I don't know, only time will tell.
Nazriya, what do you think should be done to make this place a more better environment for women working in cinema?
I think it's slowly getting there, like, you know, at least now everyone has a say, like, you know, let it be WCC or Amma. I mean, women are speaking nowadays. I mean, you know, everything should be spoken and, you know, sorted.
I just think there's a problem with generalizing it, you know, because a kind of, it's not one world, there are worlds within cinema. So I can for sure say that in my world of cinema, I have never heard a woman complaining. I know for a fact that she wouldn't complain about her sets, because I don't think it's fair generalizing cinema as a whole.
Like, I keep telling you, when people discuss such things with me, like, what do you have to say about it? I'm like, if it's happened, definitely it's something wrong. And people need to speak out about it. Like, you know, that's a good thing. But you can't ask me to go and speak. Something like that has never happened with me.
Exactly. Fair enough.
I understand the situation completely, but I cannot, you know, say, you know, this has happened with me also. I cannot.
Yeah. I would have to disagree if somebody implies that there is one uniform working environment all through Malayalam cinema. There isn't. It depends on the team you are working with. It depends on the kind of people you decide to associate with.
Yeah.
I'm not saying that everybody has a choice. Not everyone does have a choice. I understand that. But then again, it's not like, oh, the whole of cinema is this. Yeah, no, it's not that.
Now we are almost ready to shoot your first film as a director.
Yeah.
And what just now...
You already appointed me as your co-director. Yeah. So now you have no choice. Think about it when you
see. Yeah. So we'll come visit.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So we just heard that Vivek Oberoi has just joined the cast. What more can you divulge about the film? Anything more we can hear about the film?
Vivek didn't just join the cast. You just knew that Vivek is in the cast. Obviously, there is nothing I can divulge about the film, except for the fact that I'm starting next week. On the 16th.
Okay.
I'm starting shoot. And I mean, it's a... I think most people by now would have made out that it's the premise or the backdrop of the film is political.
Okay.
I'm hoping to make a film that that celebrates the star that Mr. Mohanlal is, and also, you know, create a stage where the actor in him can revel. I don't know how successful I will be, but I'm going to give it my best shot. It's a big film logistically and everything. It's a challenge for a debut director, but yeah, I have my team to help me. So let's see what happens.
And who all are your inspirations, and which directors do you look up to? Like,
I really can't name one, because there are a lot of filmmakers I look up to, and I can tell you for sure that every single director I have worked with, I've learned something, either what not to do or what to do. So every single filmmaker I worked with, I've learned something. And even Malayalam cinema is blessed with such legends, you know. I mean, so many people, young and old, current and past, you know, they've all inspired me. And I know that tomorrow when I design a scene or when I set up a shot, even subconsciously, I will be drawing inspiration from many, many people. Cinema essentially is an inspired craft. You have to admit it, you know, it's an inspired craft. The first filmmaker might have been inspired by a stage play. The first stage play director might have been inspired by a book. You know, the first writer might have been inspired by a tale that his grandmom told him. So it's essentially an inspired craft. And yeah, I am inspired by a lot many people, lot many creations. I don't know who and what.
Nazriya, you were quite a rage when you acted in Raja Rani in Tamil. So people in Tamil are also waiting for you to come back there. And are you planning to do a Tamil film anytime soon?
Like I said, I haven't planned anything, but like he said, I'm quite capable of doing it.
Please don't.
I haven't decided, but if something really interesting comes my way, I think I will.
Okay.
So, even when I got married, actually, I don't know who decided this for me, but I hadn't decided to stop acting. It just happened. Like my marriage.
So thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Rajata. Thank you.
Thank you.